Hi students, in the previous video we had discussed the preparation of phenol from the chlorobenzene, and in this video we are still working with the preparations of phenols, and we will also discuss the chemical reactions of the alcohols and phenols, how they will take place. Let us see the second preparation of phenol. That is, we are going to prepare the phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. We are going to prepare phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. What is the formula of this benzene sulfonic acid? Benzene we have given. Sulfonic acid is having the group of atoms SO3H. So this is what we call benzene sulfonic acid. Initially, how do we get this benzene sulfonic acid? Means we will react benzene with oleum. Oleum is the compound having the formula H2S2O7. Is one of the method of preparation. In the first year we have learned one more method, that is when benzene is reacted with concentrated sulfuric acid, also we can prepare the benzene sulfonic acid. Now this benzene sulfonic acid, we will react it with sodium hydroxide, and later it will be treated with mineral acid. It will be treated with mineral acid to give H plus ion, and the final product will be the phenol. Let us study the mechanism here. How is this process taking place? The step by step process we call as the mechanism. In the mechanism, we are using benzene sulfonic acid as a starting reactant. The benzene sulfonic acid will be first treated with aqueous NaOH, means the sodium hydroxide dissolved in water is called aqueous NaOH. The sulfonic acid, the name we can observe, it is ready to give a H plus ion. Due to the acidic hydrogen, it is ready to give the H plus ion. It is going to be substituted with the sodium ion. The H plus ion is going to be substituted with the sodium ion, forming SO3 minus and Na plus. We call this one as sodium benzene sulfonic acid. Sodium benzene sulfonic acid. It is now going to be fused with, means reacted with sodium hydroxide at a very high temperature of 350 degrees Celsius. Then what is going to happen means the SO3 group is going to be replaced with oxide. This entire group is going to be replaced with oxide. Which oxide means the O minus and Na plus. So this is what we call sodium. This is a sodium phenoxide. The product is the sodium phenoxide. We are going to react this obtained sodium phenoxide compound with HCl. It is going to give a proton, the H plus, that is going to substitute the sodium, and it is going to form the final product So we got the compound finally phenol. The phenol is obtained by reacting benzene sulfonic acid with sodium aqueous in your OH to give sodium benzene sulfonic acid, that is fused with NaOH at 350 degrees Celsius, which is going to give sodium phenoxide as an intermediate. Upon reacting with a mineral acid like HCl, the protonated H plus will replace the sodium giving the phenol. So this is for the mechanism. But in examinations we can write the rare state. Mechanism is useful for the objective purpose to understand. So let us say the third preparation of phenol, that is using a primary amine. So let us see the third preparation of phenol from aromatic primary amines. What is meant by the group amine? Amines are the group of atoms that are derived from the hydrocarbons by replacing one of the hydrogen with the NH2 group. We have RNH2. It is called as an aliphatic amine. Aliphatic amine. When the NH2 group attached carbon is bonded to only one carbon, we call it as a primary amine. If it is bonded to two carbons, secondary. If it is bonded to three carbons, tertiary. Now let us see here, this an RNH2 group of atoms. Pardon, here we are going to take the aromatic amines. Aromatic amines. Aromatic amines are the one in which NH2 is bonded to a benzene ring. That is an aromatic compound. When the nitrogen is bonded to only one carbon, it is called primary aromatic amine. If the nitrogen is bonded to two other carbons, like here CH3, you can see the nitrogen is bonded to two other carbons, then it is called as a secondary amine. If the nitrogen is bonded to three other carbons, then it is called as the tertiary amine. So presently our task is to prepare phenol from the primary aromatic amine. So let us see what is the example we are going to use here. We are going to use the example name benzene having the NH2 group oil and the nitrogen will have one lone pair. It is what we call aniline. The aniline will be reacted with the reactants like NaNO2, sodium. So let us take the example of primary aromatic amine. The NH2 group is bonded to only one carbon and it is of a benzene ring. The compound we call as the aniline. For this aniline, we are going to add the components like NaNO2, sodium nitrite. Its name is called as the sodium nitrite. Followed by, we will add hydrochloric acid. We will add hydrochloric acid. Then it will form an intermediate, that is where we find the two nitrogens are bonded to the benzene. Further, there is an chlorine nearby. On these nitrogens there will be a positive charge and the chlorine will be a negative charge. This intermediate compound we are going to call it as benzene diazonium chloride. This is called as the benzene di. Di means 2, azo means nitrogen, diazonium chloride, very important intermediate, benzene diazonium chloride. If it is hydrolyzed just by warming or little heating, it will give the product phenol and also byproduct HCl. Let us see how is it taking place. That is what the process we call mechanism. Initially, the reagents are sodium nitrite and hydrochloric acid. When the sodium nitrite and hydrochloric acid were added, how do they react with each other? Means hydrogen will displace the sodium, forming HNO2, nitrous acid. What is the acid called? Nitrous acid. And another byproduct is sodium chloride. This is the main important acid that we need in this reaction. That is called nitrous acid. This nitrous acid is going to react with the aniline. In the aniline, we had already mentioned that the nitrogen is having two hydrogens on it. The nitrous acid, how it will be arranged is like N double bonded O, OH, nitrous acid, HNO2 arrangement we are observing. The hydrogens, when removed by the oxygen, it will be burning like they both will be removed in the form of water, and it is going to form nitrogen. There is a double bond between both of the nitrogens, and we had our OH. Now this so-called reactant will be treated by hydrochloric acid. 1 mole. We are using initially 1 mole. So this protonation takes place. Protonation means on the oxygen there will be the lone pairs. They will give the lone pairs to the hydrogen, and this part of atoms, they are going to be removed in the form of water. And the lone pairs that are present on the nitrogen bonded to the benzene, they will be involved in conjugation with the next nitrogen, letting this group of atoms to be removed completely in the form of H2O. The group of atoms are removed in the form of H2O. And the nitrogen, as it is involving its lone pair, it is getting a triple bond with another nitrogen and also a positive charge on it. Now, this positively charged nitrogen will be having the chloride ion here to it. That is we call the benzene diazonium chloride. This is called as the benzene diazonium chloride. In short, it represents as BDC, benzene diazonium chloride. Upon hydrolysis, treating with water and by warming, this group of atoms will be removed and there we get HOH. Please study the water, how it is like. It is like HNOH. Observe, hydrogen and chlorine, they will form HCl. What are they forming? They are forming the HCl. The main products are OH will be bonded with the benzene, forming phenol and the hydrogen will combine with chlorine to form HCl and here remaining hydrogens they are removed in the form of the nitrogen gas. So let us recall the points again. Initially ethylene is reacted with nitrous acid that is generated by treating NaNO2 with HCl. It is going to form an intermediate that is N double bonded N and the OH. When it is reacted with first mole of HCl, the OH group will be removed with hydrogen in the form of water. The lone pairs will be involved in conjugation with the nitrogen. Hence the nitrogen develops a positive charge, forming a triple bond with another nitrogen. Negatively charged chloride will be near to it, forming the benzene diazonium chloride. On warming with water, the hydrogen and chlorine will form HCl. Nitrogen will form N2 gas. OH will be present on the benzene, forming the phenol. So this is the important mechanism. We just want only the direct reaction for the board examinations. Mechanism is to understand. Let us see the fourth preparation of phenol. That is from cumene. We shall continue what is meant by cumene. So let us see the fourth preparation of phenol from cumene. What is meant by the meaning cumene or what is its formula? Let us take a carbon. We know carbon can form four bonds. One of the bond is with hydrogen. Another bond is with methyl. One more bond is with methyl. And another bond is with benzene. So let's study what we can call this longest chain. The longest chain, there are three carbon atoms in length. So we can call this one as isopropyl group. What we can call this one as the isopropyl group. Isopropyl. This part is bonded to benzene. Hence we call this one as the isopropyl benzene, or the another name we give for this one is the cumene. Cumene on oxidation. Cumene. So let us take the cumene, which is also called as isopropyl benzene. On oxidation, it is going to form a bond between the carbon and there is an peroxide group involved between carbon and hydrogen. It is called cumene hydroperoxide. What is this called? Cumene hydroperoxide. Hydro means hydrogen, peroxide. In short, cumene hydroperoxide. This cumene hydroperoxide, once we react it with acidic medium hydrolysis. Acidic medium hydrolysis means when we react water with any mineral acid, it will form the hydronium ion. That hydronium ion, once we add, it is going to form a compound in where OH group will be bonded to the benzene. Remaining part will be forming like CH3, C double bonded O, CH3, and the OH will be bonded to the benzene, forming the phenol. The remaining part we call as the acetone. This is the industrial preparation for acetone. We can get more amount of acetone in this mechanism. We don't have any mechanism here. Only the point is, we react cumene or undergoing oxidation, that will form cumene hydroperoxide and acidic medium hydrolysis. It is going to form acetone, which will be obtained in more amount, and also the phenol. Very important for the board examinations. So, today we are discussing the preparations of phenols from chlorobenzene, from benzene sulfonic acid, from primary aromatic amine, and from cumene. Now, let us continue with the chemical reactions of the alcohols and phenols. So, let us see the chemical reactions of alcohols and phenols. These chemical reactions are nothing but the chemical properties of alcohols and phenols. There are many sub-concepts in this main concept. This is the largest concept in this chapter. So we will break or fragment the concepts and we will learn children. So let us see what is meant by the chemical reaction of alcohol and phenol. These alcohols, let us study first. They can act both as nucleophile and also electrophile. Alcohols acts as nucleophiles and also as electrophiles. So they show both the property, like a nucleophile and also as an electrophile. When do they will act as a nucleophile? When do they will act as an electrophile? If they are acting as nucleophile, what will happen? If they are acting as electrophile, what will happen? We will understand now. Let us take a general example. RCH2OH. This OH I am writing as oxygen single bonded hydrogen, and on the oxygen there are two lone pairs of electrons. Now, if at all a carbon is there bearing a positive charge, generally we call it as the carbocation. It is an electron deficient center. Electron deficient center. And there are more protons here. There are more protons. Protons are more. Hence, our so-called alcohol, once we study, the lone pairs can be donated to the positively charged carbon. Whenever it is donating the lone pairs to the positively charged carbon, we say it is going to act like a nucleophile, because nucleophiles are nucleus-liking species. As on losing of electrons, the oxygen will develop a positive charge on it. Oxygen will develop a positive charge on it. In return, we got a carbon, it got some three bonds. We are not mentioning what the bonds are. Now, as electrons are lost, this oxygen is bearing a positive charge on it. In order to neutralize its positive charge, it is going to withdraw the electrons back from the hydrogen, because hydrogen is less electronegative than carbon. Hence, the highly electronegative oxygen is withdrawing the electrons from least electronegativity element hydrogen back to neutralize this positive charge. It is going on to remove the hydrogen in the form of H+. In this case, what did we observe means, we had observed there is an cleavage of RCH2OH. When we observe, there is a cleavage of There is an carriage of oxygen hydrogen bond. Means whenever our alcohol is acting like a nucleophile, there will be a cleavage of oxygen hydrogen bond. That is the main thing we observe. Under the chemical properties, there are only two major chemical properties. Cleavage of OH bond, and also the second one is cleavage of ROH. Between carbon and oxygen, there will be a bond cleavage. So there are two kinds of cleavages: oxygen hydrogen bond and carbon oxygen bond. In the first case, will happen whenever alcohol is acting like a nucleophile. Then when does the carbon oxygen bond will be cleaved? Let's see. So let us see now, when do there will be a cleavage between carbon oxygen bond? Let us examine the same. RCH2OH we got. Previous example we had taken a carbocation, an electrophile. But now we are taking a proton ion. In this case also, oxygen will be involving in donating the lone pairs of electrons to the H plus, forming RCH2OHNH. This is what we call protonated alcohol. It is called as the protonated alcohol. Now our oxygen, we can study, it is withdrawing electrons from hydrogens, and also it is trying to withdraw the electron from carbon due to minus I effect. And this carbon will also develop an partial positive charge on it. Means it is going to start the process of searching for electrons. If any base, like a strong base, is going to donate the electrons for the carbon, then this group of atoms will be removed out. Condition is, the protonated alcohols, when treated with strong base, that is going to give electrons for carbon, and there is a bond breakage between carbon and oxygen. There is a bond breakage between carbon and oxygen. Here we observe cleavage between carbon and oxygen. So when do there will be a cleavage between carbon and oxygen? Means when the protonated alcohol is reacted with a base, then only there will be a cleavage between carbon and oxygen bond. These two points we must not forget. So there are two main kinds of cleavages: cleavage between oxygen and hydrogen, cleavage between carbon and hydrogen. So based on this, our topics are going to be continued now. So let's take the first continuity topic, cleavage of OH bond. Oxygen hydrogen bond cleavage is going to take place. Under this, the first one that we are studying is reactivity with metals. How is an alcohol going to react with a metal? Generally, the alcohol, when we study, they are ready to displace hydrogen from the alcohol. They are ready to displace hydrogen from the alcohol, like ROH plus Na. Sodium, which is highly reactive than hydrogen, it is going to displace the hydrogen and it is going to form RO minus Na plus. That it is an alkoxide ion. Alkoxide ion. Sodium alkoxide ion is the best name. We cannot send hydrogen alone. It must be removed in the form of hydrogen gas. So we need to use 2 moles of alcohol and also 2 moles of sodium. By this, what we can confirm is alcohols are acidic in nature. Acidic in nature. Because generally acids are react with metals to form the salt and hydrogen gas. So by this we can say alcohols are having it acidic in nature. The same we are going with phenol. The phenol, when reacted with sodium metal, when reacted with sodium metal, like alcohols where take the 2 moles, it will form O minus Na plus. Sodium phenoxide ion. Sodium phenoxide ion. And also along with the hydrogen gas is released. By this we say phenols are acidic in nature. Phenols are acidic in nature. So this is what we want to consider. Alcohols are acidic in nature and phenols are also acidic in nature. In the next points we will see which one is more acidic. Alcohol is more acidic or phenol is more acidic. Up to present session what we discussed is alcohols when reacted with sodium metal will form sodium alkoxide ion. Phenols when reacted with sodium metal will form sodium phenoxide ion. The same reaction can also be achieved by reacting phenol with aqueous NaOH. When we react phenol with sodium aqueous NaOH, sodium will displace the hydrogen forming O minus Na plus, but in this case we will get water. So these are the properties to say alcohols are acidic in nature and also phenols are acidic in nature. In the next class we will see which is more acidic and why.